aware as entertainers, if you like, that the shape of the show is vitally important. A lot of people have no concept of this, but you can't just put songs together willy-nilly and expect the whole thing to work. You have to have a shape to maximise your impact.
Basically, blind and deafen them in the first 10 minutes. While they're recovering from that, slip a few not quite so good ones in. And probably, you know, like, do a few things that people recognise. And
take it down, do something slow, something that takes a little more thought, maybe a medley or whatever, and then gradually build to the next climax. But basically the beginning and end of a show is vital, and we were very aware of that. There were a lot of arguments in the studios, you know, this is my song, I want it to be put forward, etc. On tour, less so, because somehow it's blindingly obvious what's working and what isn't. And that's what everybody cares about. So there wasn't really very much consideration about, you know, this is my song and I want to play it. We would try it, and if it worked, great, and if it didn't, then fine. Yeah, I think touring is a great leveller, and we never really had serious fallouts on tour, whereas we always did in the studio, where you're trying to chisel out new paths. The road was the road, the gig was the gig, and the object was clear. You just take that audience, which will never happen again for that moment, and you give them every single thing that you have in your armoury, and we used to say send them out deafened and blinded and wanting more.
That was a fun tour. I remember it being particularly good. And it was nice because we were doing very big places, which is quite hard in Europe, you know, because it's you know, we're doing big outdoor stadiums in most places, and where they weren't available, we'd do big indoor stadiums. And they were all full, which was great, you know. One dream, one soul.
I very much enjoyed translating the recorded experience onto the live experience, and very often I preferred it. Because you're able to get pretty airy-fairy on a record. On stage you have really the four instruments. You know, we had a keyboard player, Spike, with us most of the time, but basically it's guitar, bass and drums and vocal. And it brings you back to the basics.
And we just used to sort of play, get as much of the essence of the song as we could, and then make it a bit more exciting, if we could. But obviously we were limited in numbers because there are only three voices, really. And so we were limited in that sense, that we couldn't do massive, great harmonies. But, you know, it's amazing, surprising what you can cover with three voices.
And something like a kind of